Welcome you all for the class of discrete mathematical structures. Subject code 18CS36. I'll be teaching a topic in module 1, fundamentals of logic. Topic name, the basic definitions of propositions, logical equivalence, and writing down the truth tables. Myself, Dr. Madhura, working as an assistant professor, Department of Mathematics, Sai Vidya Institute of Technology, Bengaluru. First, let us know the definition for propositions. A proposition is a statement which in a given context can be either true or false, but not both. So a proposition is a particular statement which helps us to say whether the given example or the given situation is a true or a false statement. Say, for example, Delhi is the capital of India. Delhi is the capital of India is a true statement. Secondly, another example I've taken, Karnataka is our country, which is a false statement. So propositions are nothing but the statements which helps us to know whether in the given context, the statement is a true or a false. Propositions are usually represented by small letters such as P, Q, R, S, etc. The truth or falsity of a proposition is called its truth value. So either the statement will be a true or it will be a false. So the truth or the falsity of such a statement or a proposition is known as its truth value. If a proposition is true, we will indicate its truth value by 1. If the proposition is false, then we use the symbol 0. So while writing the truth tables, we assume either zeros or ones based on the proposition statement, whether it is true or false. So we assign 1 for a truth value and we assign 0 for a false statement. Next, we will understand about logical connectives. Words or phrases like not, and, or, if, then, if and only if, which are used to form new propositions using given propositions, are called logical connectives. So suppose we wish to combine two statements and we would use some of these connectives like not, and, or, if, then, if and only if, etc. Then such propositions using these connectives are called as logical connectives. The new propositions obtained using connectives are called compound propositions. So using the connectives, whatever the new propositions we obtain, they are known as compound propositions. The original propositions from which a compound proposition is obtained are called the primitives or the components of the compound proposition. So the original proposition we have used from which using the logical connectives we obtain a compound proposition. So whatever the original propositions are there, we use them or we call them as primitives or the components of the compound proposition. Propositions which do not contain any logical connectives are called simple propositions. It is usually a proposition without any logical connective is known as simple proposition. So if you use the logical connectives like and, or, if, then, etc., then such propositions are compound propositions. Next, we will learn about negation. A proposition, or that this is also a statement, obtained by inserting the word not at an appropriate place in a given proposition is called negation of the given proposition. So negation is nothing but using not. So in a proposition, if you use the word not, if you insert the word not in the appropriate place, then we are using the negation. We are obtaining the negation of the given proposition. The negation of a proposition P is usually denoted by this symbol. We call this as tilde P. It is usually read as not P. Negation of P or not P. Conjunction, a compound proposition obtained by combining two given propositions by inserting the word and between them is called a conjunction of the given propositions. So conjunction stands for the symbol and. If we want to combine two given propositions using the word and, then the resultant would be the conjunction of the given propositions. The conjunction of P and Q is usually denoted by P and Q. The symbol is reverse V. Reverse V is the symbol used for conjunction or and. So we read this as P and Q only. The conjunction P and Q is true only when both P and Q are true. In all other cases, it is false. So it becomes very important to know about these definitions to form the truth tables. So when will P and Q be true? The truth value will be 1 only when both P and Q have the truth value 1. That is, only when both P and Q are true, we have the truth value of P and Q to be 1. In all other cases, the truth value will be 0. Next, definition is about disjunction. A compound proposition obtained by combining two given propositions by inserting the word or between them is called the disjunction of the given propositions. So suppose given two statements, we want to use the word or, then the resultant would be the disjunction of the given statements. So the disjunction of P and Q is usually denoted by P or Q. In the middle, we have a V symbol. So P or Q represents the disjunction. And the disjunction P or Q is false only when both P and Q are false. In all other cases, it is true. So P or Q has the truth value 0. Only when both P and Q have the truth value 0. False stands for truth value 0. So only when both P and Q have the truth value 0, we have P or Q also as 0. In all other cases, the truth value of P or Q is 1. That is true. Next, we'll learn about implication or conditional. A compound proposition obtained by combining two given propositions by using the words if and then at appropriate places is called a conditional or an implication. So we have a given compound proposition. We obtain a compound proposition by combining two simple propositions using the given words like if and then at appropriate places, then the resultant would be the application of conditional or an implication. If P then Q is denoted by P a right arrow Q, but we read this while doing problems as P conditional Q or P implication Q. We can also read it as if P then Q. The conditional is false. P conditional Q or P implication Q is false only when P is true and Q is false. In all other cases, this is true. So this is the rule what we apply in implication or the conditional. So we have P conditional Q taking the truth value as false only when P is true and Q is false. Means P has the truth value 1 and Q has the truth value 0. So only when it is 1, 0, the resultant P implication Q is 0. In all other cases, the truth value is 1. Next definition is about biconditional. Let P and Q be two propositions. Then the conjunction of two conditionals, P conditional Q and Q conditional P, is called the biconditional of P and Q, and it is denoted by P arrow towards both the side Q. We read this as P biconditional Q only. So we have two propositions given, which are P and Q. Then the conjunction of the two conditionals, that is P implication Q and Q implication P, we are conjunction. We are doing the conjunction means we are combining them by the notation AND, by the proposition AND, by the logical connective AND, is called the biconditional of P and Q, usually denoted by P. This is a symbol for biconditional Q. It is read as if P then Q and if Q then P. We have P conditional Q, no? It is read as if P then Q, and Q conditional P is read as if Q then P. Next is about exclusive disjunction. The compound proposition notation in this form, P, we have a V and there's a underline below it, Q, read as either P or Q but not both, is called the exclusive disjunction of the propositions P and Q. So this notation is usually read as exclusive disjunction of the two propositions P and Q, and usually read as either P or Q but not both. Equivalently, exclusive disjunction of P and Q is true only when either P is true or Q is true, but not both. So this is the symbol denoted for exclusive disjunction, and this P exclusive disjunction Q is true only when either P is true or Q is true, but not when both. Next, we will see the truth table for all the notations that we learned now. The logical connectives, that is negation, and, or, if and only if, then. So for all that, we'll put it in the form of a table and understand how the truth values are represented. So this is the table for us. I have taken two propositions P and Q. We fill the values starting from 00, 01, 10, 11. That is, when both P and Q are false, P is false, Q is true, P is true, Q is false, and finally when both P and Q are true. So negation P, you have 0, so negation P gives you 1. If you have 1, negation P gives us 0. Then the next one is P and Q. P and Q, or the conjunction of P and Q. So conjunction of P and Q. When is P and Q true? Only when both P and Q are true, its truth value of P and Q is also 1. Only when both P and Q has a truth value 1, the truth value of P and Q will also be 1. In all other cases, the truth value will be 0. Similarly, for P or Q, P or Q is false only when both P and Q are false. In all other cases, the truth value is 1. That is, it is true. Then we have P implication Q. Recalling from the definition what we learned for implication, P implication Q is false only when P is true and Q is false. Only when P is true and Q is false, P implication Q is false. In all other cases, it is true. Then P biconditional Q. Recalling from the definition, P biconditional Q is true when both P and Q are true or both P and Q are false. So both P and Q should be false or both P and Q should be true, then only P biconditional Q will be true. It is having the truth value as 1 only when both P and Q are zeros or both P and Q are ones. The rest all cases it is 0. Then finally, P exclusive disjunction Q. It is usually read as either P or Q but not both. So this is true when either P is true or Q is true. Either P or Q should be true, only then its truth value is true or 1. In all other cases, it is 0 or false. So this is how we write down the truth table. I have taken two propositions for, that is, P and Q here. So for P and Q, we are doing this table. Similarly, if there is one more proposition or two more propositions also, we will be able to implement in the same manner and obtain the truth table. Next, we will know about tautology. A compound proposition which is true for all possible truth values of its components is called a tautology. So we simplify the compound proposition, and the simplified form of the composition proposition has the truth value 1 in all possible truth values of its components, then such a compound proposition is called tautology. About contradiction, a compound proposition which is false for all possible truth values of its components is called a contradiction or an absurdity. So we say that if all the truth values of each components are zeros, then such a compound proposition is called as contradiction. Contingency. A compound proposition that can be true or false depending upon the truth values of its components is called a contingency. So the table will have a mixture of truth values 1 and zeros. So it can be either true or false depending upon the truth values of the components. Then such a compound proposition is called contingency. Next, we have logical equivalence. Two propositions U and V are said to be logically equivalent whenever U and V have the same truth value. Or equivalently, we can write down the biconditional U biconditional V is a tautology. So for the given proposition, when you perform U biconditional V, if the truth value of each components are 1, then we say it is a tautology, no? So if the biconditional is a tautology, we can conclude that U is logically equivalent to V. Or in other way, if we have to prove the logical equivalence of two propositions U and V, they are said to be logically equivalent if they have the same truth value. Symbolically, it can be written as U is logically equivalent to V, or U is logically equivalent to V. So these are the symbols that are used here, implies and implies by symbol, or the three parallel lines. So these two are the notations for logical equivalence, and usually this is read as U is logically equivalent to V. Now, based on all these concepts, that is about logical equivalence, writing down the truth tables, we will do problems. Let us do problems now. Problems. First question. Let PQR be propositions having truth values 0, 0, and 1 respectively, having truth values 0, 0, and 1 respectively. Find the truth values of the following compound proposition. Find the truth values of the following compound propositions. Find the truth value of the following compound propositions. First one, P or Q or R. Second one, P and Q and R. Third one, P and Q conditional R. Fourth one, P conditional Q and R. Fifth one, P and R conditional Q. Sixth one, P conditional Q conditional negation R. So given the truth values of P, Q, R as respectively 0, 0 and 1, we have to find the truth values of the given compound propositions. So we'll just do one by one. We'll frame a small table in each of the cases and do PQR has the truth values 0, 0 and 1, 0, 0, 1. The first one we have to find is P or Q. So first we will be finding P or Q, and then we will use P or Q or R. P or Q or R. So we will just frame the table and do it so that things will be easy for us to understand. So P, Q, R are given respectively as 0, 0, 1. We have to use P or Q. Recall the definition for disjunction P or Q. P or Q, both P and Q have the truth value 0 and 0. So P or Q will also have the truth value 0. Then we have P or Q or R. So P or Q has the truth value 0. R has the truth value 1. So 0 or 1 gives us 1. So this was the first sub question for us. Similarly, we have to do the remaining second one. Second one, we have to do P and Q and R. So first we will do P and Q, then we will implement P and Q and R. So truth value of P is given as 0, truth value of Q is given as 0, R truth value is 1. And for P and Q, both are zeros, so resultant for AND, that is conjunction, is also 0. You have to remember the rules for each one of them. For conjunction, disjunction, implication and all that, we have to remember the rule. So rule for P and Q is, when both P and Q are 1, only then P and Q is also 1. The rest all cases it is 0, that is why we have written 0 here. Now P and Q and R is also 0 because 0 and 1 we are doing. Only when both are 1, the resultant would have been 1. Since this is 0, we have the resultant as 0 in the conjunction. Then we have third one. I'll write down the truth values of PQR, that is 0, 0, 1 as it is. Then we have to find P and Q conditional R. So first we will do P and Q, which is 0, because we have already seen it in the previous case also. P and Q is 0. We have to now imply P and Q conditional R, we have to do. So P and Q conditional R. Conditional R we have to implement. P and Q is 0, 0 conditional 1. 0 conditional 1 is 1. 0 conditional 1 is 1. Remember the implication. Only when P is true and Q is false, the resultant P conditional Q is false. Rest all are zeros. So only when you have 1, 0, the resultant is 0. Rest all cases are 1. That is the definition of a conditional. That's the reason we have 0, 1 here. P and Q is 0, 0 conditional 1 we are doing, the resultant is 1. If you have 1, 0, then only resultant is 0. Now moving ahead to the fourth one. Fourth one, we have to perform P conditional Q and R. So first we have to do Q and R, no? First we have to do Q and R. First we will write on PQR and its truth value. Truth values are 0, 0, 1 respectively. First we need to perform Q and R. Then we'll have to do P conditional Q and R. What is Q and R? Q and R, AND means conjunction. Conjunction is 1 only when both Q and R are 1. One of them is 0, so resultant here is 0. P conditional Q and R. P is 0, Q and R is 0. So 0 conditional 0 is 1. If you have P as 1, Q and R as 0, then it will be 1, 0. 1, 0 will be 0. In all other cases, it will be 1. That's the definition of a implication or the condition. Right? Now, fifth one. Fifth one, we have to do P and R conditional Q. So first, we will have to perform R conditional Q, followed by we have to do AND with P. I'll just do that in the next page. So fifth one, what we have to do? First, I will write down the truth values of P, Q, R. Then I have to do R conditional Q and then AND with P. Right now? So first, we will write down P, Q, R has the truth value 0, 0, 1. Then we have to perform R conditional Q followed by P and R conditional Q. P and R conditional Q. So R conditional Q gives us 1, 0. Read it reversely. 1, 0, because we are doing R conditional Q. So 1, 0 is 0 in the conditional. 1, 0 is 0 in the conditional. Now we have to perform P and R conditional Q. P is 0, R conditional Q is 0. And between them, both are zeros means resultant is 0 in the conjunction. Now the next one, that is sixth one, P conditional, Q conditional, negation R. So after we have written R, we have to first write down negation R. Then we need to perform Q conditional negation R. Then we have to imply P conditional, Q conditional, negation R. Do it according to the brackets. So we'll do one by one. So firstly, we have to write down the truth values of P, Q, R, which are 0, 0, 1 respectively. We have to first do negation R. Then we have to implement Q conditional negation R. Then finally, P conditional, Q conditional negation R. Right? So negation R will be 0. If you have the truth value as 1, negation of that value will be 0. If you have the truth value of R 0, then negation R will be 1. Vice versa. So R has the truth value 1. That's why negation R has the truth value 0. Next, Q conditional negation R. Q is 0. Negation R is 0. Q conditional negation R will be 1. In conditional, only when you have 1, 0, resultant is 0. Rest all cases, it is 1 only. So that is why Q conditional negation R is 1. Now we have P conditional of Q condition of negation R. So P is 0, Q conditional negation R is 1. So 0, 1 gives us 1 itself. 0, 1 gives us 1. So this was the basic problem which I took to make you understand about the simple definitions of conjunction, disjunction, negation, implication, and all. Second problem, show that for any two propositions, P and Q, first one, P exclusive or Q, or P biconditional Q is a tautology. Second one, P exclusive or Q and P conditional Q is a contingency. Third one, P exclusive or Q and P biconditional is a contradiction. Is a contradiction. So again, using the truth table, we will be able to do the problem. So let us see how to do solution. Solution. We'll form a truth table, writing down starting from PQ. You observe that only P and Q are the two propositions you are having. So we will fill the table with only P and Q. PQ. Will be in need of P exclusive or Q. Will be in need of P biconditional Q. P biconditional Q. And in the third one, if you observe, we also have P conditional Q. We also have in the second one, P conditional Q. So let us frame these and do the first, second and the third part of the problem. We'll write out the truth values of all these first, starting from 00, 01, 10, 11. So these are the different possibilities of the truth values that exist for two propositions P and Q. Now what is the definition of exclusive or P exclusive or Q we have to find out. P exclusive or says the rule that it is true only when either P is true or Q is true, but not both. So either P should be true or Q should be true. Then only P exclusive or Q is true. This is P exclusive or Q is true only when either P is true or Q is true. So here are the true values for us. Rest all cases it is false. P biconditional Q. We have P biconditional Q rule as P biconditional Q is true only if both P and Q are true or both P and Q are false. Both P and Q should be true or both P and Q should be false. So it is in the first case, you observe both P and Q are false. So P biconditional Q is true. P and Q are both true in the last case. So P biconditional Q is also true. Rest all cases it is false. Rest all cases it is false. Then we have P conditional Q. P conditional Q only when 1, 0 we have, the resultant is 0, rest all cases it is 1. So only when it is 1, 0, it is 0, rest all cases it is 1. So this is for P conditional. Now we will have to do one by one. First case is P exclusive or Q or P biconditional Q. So we'll call these expressions P exclusive or Q as X for convenient. Similarly, we will call P biconditional Q as Y for convenient. So first one, are we performing X or Y? We are performing X or Y, no? X is nothing but P exclusive or Q. Y is nothing but P biconditional Q. There is or in the middle, so we are performing X or Y. We are performing X or Y. So what does X or Y give? Or, that is disjunction. Disjunction says that only when both the truth values are 0, resultant is 0. If one of them is 1, then the resultant will be 1. So X or Y gives us 1 in all the cases here. X or Y gives us 1 in all the cases. Why it is? Because we are performing 0, 1 is 1, 0 or 1 is 1, 1 or 0 is also 1, 1 or 0 is 1, 0 or 1 is also 1. That is the definition for OR, disjunction. This is the answer for the first case. For the first case, this is the answer. Now for the second one, P exclusive or Q and P conditional Q. Here you have P conditional Q, no? So just for convenient, we will write down P conditional Q as Z. Just for convenient, we will represent this as Z. So what are we supposed to perform? We are supposed to perform P exclusive or Q, that is X and Z. So we are supposed to perform X and Z. So we will do that. X and Z we are performing. So what does AND gives? AND says that only when both the truth values are 1, resultant is 1. Rest all cases it is 0. So you have to look into this column, P exclusive or Q, that is X and Z. So you have 0, 1, so resultant is 0 and the AND. You have 1, 1, so resultant is 1. And you have 1, 0, so resultant is 0. The last one is also 0 and 1. 0 and 1 also resultant is 0. So did you observe it is a mixture of zeros and ones? This is the answer for the second case. We observe that it is a mixture of zeros and ones, which is nothing but contingency. Did you observe the answer for the first one, that it is all truth values are all one? So first one is a tautology. Second one is a mixture of zeros and ones, so it is a contingency. Third one, I will leave it to the students to do. We have to perform P exclusive Q and P biconditional Q and show that it is a contradiction. Contradiction means all your truth values should be zero. All your truth values, when you perform this compound proposition, the truth values on in all the cases should be zero. So try doing that. I will conclude for first and second one, right? So first and the second results are satisfied. Why first and second results are satisfied? First one, we have proved the truth values of all of them are one. So it is a tautology. Second one, we have proved it is a mixture of zeros and ones. So that is why it is a contingency. Third one, you have to do it by yourself. You have to prove and get the resultant as zeros in the truth table when you perform this X and Y. When you perform this X and Y, your resultant has to be all zeros. So you can conclude it is a contradiction. We'll do third problem, proving the resultant for a tautology. Third one, prove that for any propositions P, Q, R, for any propositions P, Q, R, the compound proposition given by P or Q and P conditional R and Q conditional R, put a big bracket for this, conditional R is a tautology. So we have to prove the condition. We have three compound propositions P, Q, R for us. So we need to perform the compound proposition P or Q and P conditional R and Q conditional R. The whole thing conditional R is a tautology we have to prove. Tautology means the resultant proposition should be all ones, having the truth values as all being ones. So let us start performing this using the truth table. सॉल्यूशन पी क्यू आर पी और क्यू देन वी वांट पी कंडीशनल आर देन वी हैव टू परफॉर्म क्यू कंडीशनल आर and we observe that we have p or q and p conditional r and q conditional r. So just for simplification I can assume these as x, y and z. Just to be on the simpler side, I am assuming this proposition as x, y, z respectively, so that you have to now perform x and y and z, no? X and y and z. Still the work is not over. So this big bracket becomes x and y and z. Conditional R you have to perform. Okay, we will just do that. If possible, try to do it in one particular columns, one set of columns, so that it is all in one line. Okay. So we have the write down the truth values of each one of these first. We will write down the truth values now. P, Q, R. So 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1. Then we have 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, and finally 1, 1, 1. So 8 different possibilities are there. So these are the 8 different possibilities. Try to go in an order so that you will not mess up and do wrong. Okay. Only when you go in an order, things will be always easy for us to proceed. So you have to now perform P or Q. You have to now perform P or Q. Or. So any one of them is 1, resultant is 1. So we have 0, 0. 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. Or says that when you are looking for P and Q, look into the first two columns only. P or Q you are performing, that is disjunction. Truth value of 0 or 1 is 1. If one of them is 1, it is sufficient to write down 1. If both are zeros or the truth value of both P and Q are false, then P or Q is false. Rest all cases it is true. So same thing we have written. Next we have P conditional R. First in the third column you have to look into. P conditional R is 0 only when P is true and R is false. P is true, R is false. 1, 0. Only when it is 1, 0, resultant is 0. So 1, 0, resultant is 0. Again we have one more here, 1, 0, P and R column you have to look into. So 1, 0 resultant is 0. Rest all cases the resultant is 1. Rest all cases the resultant is 1. Now we have to perform Q conditional R. Second and the third column, we have to look into Q conditional R. Again, only when you have 1, 0, the resultant is 0. Rest all cases, it is 1. So third row, you have 1, 0. 1, 0 is 0. Then again, the seventh row, you have 1, 0 as 0. That's all, no? Rest all cases will be one. All other cases are one only. Now we are performing x and y and z. For convenient, I had already taken p or q as x, p conditional r as y, q conditional r as z. So now we are performing x and y and z. X and y and z. So and would mean all the three, means conjunction. When all the three are one, the resultant is one. Rest all cases it is zero. So fourth row we have all the values of x, y, z as one. So resultant is one in the fourth row. Again, in the last row, we observe x, y, z all are 1. So, resultant is 1. If any one of them have zeros, x and y and z, the resultant will be 0 only. So, we'll fill zeros in the remaining places. So, this is x and y and z. Now, we have to perform x and y and z conditional R. Conditional R. We will perform that. I will just write down the answer here in the beside column. Just putting one column there. You try to manage it before only and put the columns accordingly. So here is my final answer. Answer I am writing at the last column here. Answer in the sense, I have to prove this is a tautology, no? So I am performing, what am I actually performing? I will write down here putting an arrow. So I will just write it in the other ink so that you can get differentiated. So what am I actually performing is X and Y and Z conditional R. X and Y and Z conditional R I am performing. Correct, no? What is the result? And then x and y and z conditional R column, third column you have to look. So you are reading the other way. This column you have to read it first and then R column you have to read. And for conditional, only when you have 1, 0, resultant is 0. So I have to check whether I have 1, 0. So in this column it is 1 here. The respective column of R has also 1. Again you have 1 here at the last. So respective column of R also has 1. Only in the conditional, only when it is 1, 0, the resultant is 0. But we observe there are no 1, 0 happening. So all the values will give you 1 itself. The resultant is 1 itself. So we have proved that X and Y and Z conditional R has the truth values 1 in each of the compound propositions. So we can conclude that the required resultant is a tautology. So we can conclude, therefore, P or Q and P conditional R and Q conditional R, the whole conditional R is a tautology. Is a tautology. Next, fourth one. Use truth tables to verify negation P and negation Q and R, you can write down appropriate brackets properly, or Q and R or P and R is logically equivalent to R. Hope you can recall, this is the symbol for logical equivalence. So definition of logical equivalence says that for each of the compound propositions, irrespective of the truth values, whatever the truth values you have on the left-hand part should be same as R, right? If I assume this as entire expression as U and R as V, then I have to prove that U is logically equivalent to V. They should have the same truth values. Then we can conclude that the entire expression in the left-hand part is logically equivalent to R. Let us do the solution for the same. I prepared this table so that we can have values now. So we have three compound propositions, three propositions, that is P, Q, R. So first three columns I prepared as P, Q, R. We observe in the first expression, I have negation P, I have negation Q, and I have negation Q and R. In a bracket, small bracket, we have negation Q and R. Then finally, the first big bracket says that it is negation P and negation Q and R. So I have just denoted for convenience as X. Okay. Now we will fill in the values of PQR. PQR takes the values. They take the values as 000, 001, 010, etc. We'll fill them first now. So we have 000, 001, 010. Then we have 011. Then 100, 101, 110, and finally 111. We will fill the table negation P. So negation P means if you have 0, result will be 1. No? So like that we will fill. Then we have negation Q. Looking into Q column, negate it. So we have 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0. Next column will be negation Q and R. So next column I have to perform negation Q and R. So negation Q is this column, just now what we obtained, and with R. So only when both are 1, resultant is 1. So second row is 1 for me. And then we have, that's all. Okay, now there's one more, sixth row as 1, no? Sixth row is also 1. So you have negation Q and R. Negation Q is 1, 1. And then here again, with R you are doing, so R column you have to look into. So only when both are 1 in the AND, that is conjunction, resultant is 1. So rest all are filled with zeros now. Rest all are filled with zeros. Next we have negation P and negation Q and R. Negation Q and R is just now what we obtained, that column. We have to do AND with negation P. Negation P we have obtained already. So when is both 1, you have to look into. It is fourth column and the sixth column I am looking. Right? When both are 1, resultant is 1. Rest all are zeros. Rest all are zeros. So only we observe that the second row is 1. Second row, resultant is 1. All others are zeros. So this is the resultant what we obtained now. Now this is just X for us. Okay, I have to do still Q and R or P and R. Since I have a lack of columns required here, so I'll just move on to the next page. You can just continue in the same table. Try to do it in one particular row wise. At a stretch, if you are able to complete, you will have a better clarity. Now I prepared this table so that it will be convenient for us to look into and proceed. I have to next proceed doing Q and R, P and R, and OR between them. Correct? Same thing I have prepared. Q and R, P and R, and there is a OR between them. which I called it for convenient as y. So this was our second big bracket in the left hand part. So now I have to perform x or y at last. So performing x or y at last, right? What to show? X or y has the same truth values as of r column. That is, then we will be proving that it is logically equivalent, right? No? So we will now perform q and r, p and r. Since we are all now familiar with the and between the two propositions, we'll just write down the values. So q and r has the values 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Q and R has these values. We are all familiar with and between, no? So only when both are 1, the resultant is 1. Again, the last row we can observe both are 1. So that is why resultant is 1. So rest all are filled with zeros. Similarly, P and R we have to do. P and R. So we have both being 1 only in the 6th row and the 8th row. P and R. So that is why 6th row and 8th row will have 1. Rest all will be filled by zeros. 6th row as well as 8th row will be 1. Rest all will be filled by zeros. So this is for P and R. Now we have to perform Q and R or P and R. Means or between these two. Or between these two means if any one of the truth value has 1, then the resultant is 1. Correct? So 4th row resultant is 1. 6th row resultant is 1. 8th row resultant is 1. 4th row, 6th row and 8th row resultant is 1. Rest all are zeros. Rest all are zeros. Now we have to perform x or y. We have x in the previous column or between y. Y is this column for us. So what does x or y say? X or y means if any one of them is 1 in that row, then the value is resultant will be 1 only. So second row there is a 1. So 1 or 0 gives us 1. Second row will be 1. Then we have 4th row, 6th row and 8th row as 1. 4th, 6th and 8th row as 1. When you do OR with anything that is 0 or 1, your resultant will be 1 itself. So you have 4th row 1, 6th row 1 and the 8th row 1. Now rest all will be filled by zeros. Rest all are filled by 0. So you have 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1 as your truth value for the answer in the left hand part, that is x or y. So right hand side you have to prove it is logically equivalent to r. Let us check the r column. You have r column as 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. And it was the same thing with x or y. 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. So we have proved that x or y is logically equivalent to r. Thus, from columns 3 and 11. Let us check whether it is correct. Third column is r, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. This is the 11th column result. So we are observing from columns 3 and 11, the truth values are same for all possible truth values of P, Q, R. So for all possible truth values of P, Q, R, we observe the columns 3 and 11 are same. They are same. So that is why we can conclude the left hand part is logically equivalent to the R. So that is negation P and negation Q and R or Q and R or P and R is logically equivalent to R. The given resultant, whatever was there, I wrote the same thing to you. So I'll just give one or two problem practice questions which will help you to get more idea about these two tables. Try doing them. So in that, I would like to give first one practice questions. First one, I will give the resultant to be proved as a tautology. So prove that prove that for any propositions P, Q, R, the compound proposition P or Q, conditional R, biconditional, negation R, conditional, negation of P or Q is a tautology. So you are familiar what is the tautology, no? The final resultant, what is the compound proposition that you are proving? This entire expression should have the truth values one. Okay, so this is biconditional for us. Okay, biconditional here in the middle. So you have to perform this and prove that it is a tautology. Second one, prove that for any three propositions P, Q, R, you have to prove the resultant P biconditional Q and Q biconditional R and R biconditional P. This entire expression is logically equivalent to P conditional Q and Q conditional R and R conditional P. So you have to prove for any three propositions given P biconditional Q and Q biconditional R and R biconditional P is logically equivalent to P conditional Q and Q conditional R and R conditional P. So these two practice questions will help you to have a better clarity on writing down the truth tables. Thank you.